Oh, I'm following the recipes. Why isn't my food coming out as good as yours, Judith?
I do all of my seasoning by taste. Maybe that's it.
Try changing the balance of ingredients, or adding some seasoning that's not in the recipe.
Good idea. I'll try that.
I'm surprised to hear proper cooking advice from you, Rita.
Hey, I'm not the best cook, but adding spices is like mixing chemicals. It's just chemistry.
I guess in a way. But I also feel like that's not all there is to it.
You'll be fine as long as you taste it as you go. Probably.
So do you and Yuri use your own special seasonings? Is that why your food is so good?
Exactly. If you just rely on the recipe, your cooking will never be really delicious.
Cooking is hard, but I'll keep trying. I want to learn how to make better food.
That attitude is the secret ingredient to every good dish.
Hey, look!
They're all Kritians.
Are they welcoming us?
Now this is a surprise. These visitors really are from the outside.
Well, well. So it was you who called on Myorzo.
And what is this? How strange. What curious ornaments you wear.
Hey, it's not polite to stare, you know.
How are such children as yourselves able to come here?
She's talking about you, Patty. Mm-hmm.
You too, Rita.
Is this monster an Entelechia, perhaps?
It's Baul. Have you forgotten him?
Oh, you're the one who descended to the Earth some years ago, right?
I believe Judith. Yes, Judith was your name. There was something you had to attend to, and...
Are you about finished? We would like to meet with the Elder.
Please feel free to do as you wish.
He may be out for a walk again, though.
Okay, so they're a bit weird.
That's actually called rude.
You're one to talk, Rita.
All Kritians are pretty much like that.
Like what?
Oh, easygoing, unafraid. We are dreamers and optimists, for better or worse.
The Kritians who live on the surface are like that too.
Living together with humans, the Kritians on the surface have lost some of their naivete.
So is the Elder like that too?
How should I put it? He's the perfect Elder for weird people.
Sounds like quite a unique individual. I'm trying to be nice here.
This should be interesting.
The Kritians are different than I imagined.
Oh man, I totally agree.
What's so different?
You know, more like... I thought they'd be more like you, Judith.
Yeah. I'm seeing far less skin than I expected. I mean, come on!
So that's what the two of you were looking forward to?
How juvenile.
What are you looking at me for?
I was talking about her personality!
Seriously, let's have some decency here.
Is it me, or are you a little disappointed too, Yuri?
I'd like to ask the same thing, Yuri.
It's you.
Ah, men.
Myorzo, Judy?
Yeah, when I was a kid.
What sort of kid were you?
A little shy and overindulged, maybe.
A little shy?
That's hard to picture.
It is beyond imagining, isn't it?
Everyone told me I was a strange child.
Yes, I can see that. A child being called strange by strange people.
She must have been Judy-like since she was little.
I'd like to ask you all exactly what that means to each of you.
There'd be a city in a place like this.
There's so many types of blastia I've never seen before.
Looks like the Kritians really were the ones who created blastia in the first place.
Yes, seeing all this blastia makes it very easy to believe that.
It sure would be nice if we happened upon a way to do something about your power, Miss Estelle.
Really, that would be nice, but...
It's not working.
It doesn't have a core. It's just the body.
This city has stopped using blastia. What you see here is what everyone threw out long ago.
Why would they do that?
Because that was the path we chose.
It's been a long time, Elder.
So you were the cause of all this commotion outside. You've returned to us.
These children are humans who are traveling with me.
This is blastia, is it not?
Yes, it's my Bodhi blastia that I use.
I thought that Earth dwellers had stopped using blastia, like us.
Do you not use the blastia here because it uses a special formula too?
There are no normal or special types of blastia. Blastia is made by crushing apothea and processing those pieces with technology to produce cores and through the absorption of air.
Hold it. Cores are made from crushed apothea?
Indeed, that is what the stories say. It appears apothea was too powerful in its original form. Even without that power, it is a stone more valuable than any precious gem. This is why its power was restrained by breaking it into pieces and carving formulas into it, and thus its numbers were also increased. Our legends tell us that cores were always produced in this way.
A bit ironic, huh?
Yeah. The apothea that comes from Entelechea, who hate blastia, is necessary to make the very blastia that they hate.
Maybe Pharaoh didn't tell us about apothea because he felt uncomfortable talking about it, you think?
Elder... There are many things I'd like to ask you about.
We're trying to find out what sort of role blastia played in ancient times. And if blastia ever brought disasters to this world,
We'd like to know how they might have been stopped. Myorzo must still have some folklore, right? Perhaps you could tell us what you know.
Very well. My home would be a better place to speak of such things. Please go inside and wait for me there.
Hey there, where are you going?
I was in the middle of my daily walk. I'll return to my house before too long.
Apatheia, Blastia, air disturbances, Entelechia. It looks like everything's connected.
We might even see more connections once he's told us the Kritian folklore.
The Elder's house is the large building with a differently colored roof than all the others.
Gotcha.
Patty, we're leaving.
Oh yeah, I'm coming too.